Fellow Zambians, in the next few days, our country goes to the polls to once again demonstrate and assert to the world, as we have done on numerous occasions, Zambia's democratic credentials. Historically, since we gained independence in 1964, we have lived as one people. We fought the colonial masters together. We never looked at one's tribe, race, gender, or religion. We were united so that we could live in harmony as brothers and sisters and enjoy the fruits of our land as one people. Since the reintroduction of multi-party politics in Zambia in 1990, we have held several peaceful and democratic elections. As a country, we can be proud of the manner in which we resolve electoral disputes. Aggrieved parties use the judiciary to challenge electoral outcomes that they are displeased with. We should continue with this good tradition. During my tenure as president, I emphasized the importance of contesting parties to respect the will of the people. I wish to remind the contestants in this year's elections that every election has winners and losers. Any attempt by any entity acting alone or in concert with others to impose a leadership outside the concept of one man, one vote, will be an assault on the sacrifices of our founding fathers and will imperil the sovereignty and independence of the country, and also jeopardize the peace and unity of this generation and those to come. We have chosen for ourselves a system that gives legitimacy to those in government through the ballot box. To our friends who have come from afar and near to observe this election, this is a noble and widely accepted role and practice in modern democracies. Monitors and observers ensure transparency and integrity of the elections. Indeed, our foreign friends are welcome, and we have no doubt about their competence and professionalism in this kind of undertaking. As Zambians, we have great confidence in the governance institutions we have created for ourselves. The Electoral Commission of Zambia, therefore, in this instance, must be given space and necessary cooperation and support so that it can fulfill its mandate in a satisfactory manner. Fellow citizens, there is a need to maintain peace and unity in this country as we head to the polls. I am therefore appealing to all our politicians to ensure that they do not destroy Zambia by desisting from resorting to retrogressive and divisive activities such as violence, hate speech, including ethnic and racial profiling in their campaigns or during their campaigns. Fellow countrymen and women, Zambia urgently needs development, and as such, it is anxiously waiting for the conclusion of these elections so that the implementation of this development agenda and the rebuilding of our economy can resume apace to the satisfaction of all citizens. However, because of the COVID-19 pandemic, which is ravaging the world, and Zambia has not been spared, our economy and the health status of our people have been adversely affected. It is in this light that I am making this earnest appeal and calling upon all our people as they go about their last rounds of campaigns to strictly abide by the COVID-19 regulations. This is very important, so as to safeguard the modest gains we've made so far for the future generations. If we do not abide by the COVID-19 regulations, we may end up losing a lot of lives, and the whole elections exercise will become meaningless. In conclusion, let me reiterate what I said at the beginning. In every elections, there'll be winners and losers. Winners must remain humble, magnanimous, and show respect to the losers. The losers, on the other hand, must be able to graciously accept defeat, congratulate the winners, reorganize themselves, and try again in the next election. As a country, we must all work together to ensure that peace and unity prevail before, during, and after the elections. I call upon our leaders in the various faith-based organizations and Zambians in general to pray earnestly to God Almighty for peace and preservation of this great nation. May God bless our Zambians.